Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the course Analog Circuits. Okay. Again, you have two words here, circuits and analog. Okay. So circuits are nothing but here electronic circuits. Okay. Let me write down so that it will be. Okay. So it is an very difficult to write. Okay. Fine. So it is an electronic circuits. So whatever we are discussing, it is. So for this, there are analog and digital circuits are there. So electronic circuits are majorly classified into analog and digital. Okay. So in that, we are going to continue our discussion in analog circuits. Okay. So the prerequisites for this subject you have already went through, starting from your physics. Okay. Physics, you have learned about what is semiconductors, all these things. Then you have take up basic electrical engineering. Okay. So you have learned about the basic elements, resistor, inductor, capacitor, which will be always there along with electronic circuits. And then you have taken up the course in basic electronics. Okay. So basic electronics, you have introduced to a basic devices like diode. Okay. Different types of diode. Then transistor, in that BJT is the very first element. Then FET, you have studied in FET. Again, there are JFET and MOSFET. So like that, you have classification, you have learned through, and also you have seen another type of integrated circuit. It is called as op amp. Okay. So normally it is present in 741 IC 741. Okay. Called as op amp. So that also little bit you have learned. Okay. So what is meant by that? What is its characteristics, equivalent circuit, its equivalent circuit model. Okay. And some of the circuits also you have went through. Okay. So after basic electronics, you entered the branch, you learned about network theory. Okay. So network theory, what exactly you have learned is the mesh analysis and node analysis. Okay. So it's also nothing but Kirchhoff's voltage law or Kirchhoff's current law. Okay. Then basic network theorems, which when you have very complicated circuits, we will apply the theorems. Okay. Otherwise KVL and KCL will solve the problem. Then initial conditions, Laplace transforms, all these things you went through in network theory. So that some extent you require in analyzing the electronic circuits also. Okay. So then you have went electronic devices and circuits also subject. Okay. So there you have learnt about very basic electronics like semiconductors, two types of semiconductor. Okay. N-type, P-type. Okay. So using N-type and P-type, you formed a PN junction. So PN junction is used in constructing the diode. Okay. Then if you have PNP or NPN, you will form a three terminal device called as transistor. So in transistor, you have learned BJT. Okay. So like that. So this discussion is continued. Okay. So it is not the starting point, analog circuits. So it started from your physics. Okay. Basic electrical engineering, basic electronics, electronic devices, network theory. Okay. So in network theory, you had the elements like a resistor, inductor, capacitor, and you had the voltage sources and current sources. Within that only we done the problems. Now this electronic circuits, so we will be having the electronic devices present along with resistor, inductor, capacitor. Okay, so that is the analysis here. So again, in basic electronics you have learned basic something about digital electronics also there. So that continuation you have learned in digital system design in third semester. Okay. So that is the continuation part, and this will be continued in next semester maybe. Okay. So like HDL, VLSI subjects are there. So that is that domain. Okay. So this is this path, but now we are in analog circuits going in this path. Okay. So as I told you, electronic devices and circuits, some of the small circuits also you have seen, and majorly you have seen their diode circuits like rectifiers. Okay. Diodes, rectifiers, then clippers, clampers. These are the basic diode circuits. This you have went through and you have done the lab programs also. Clear? And then the majorly nowadays the transistors or integrated circuits are manufactured using the MOSFETs. Okay. So in this subject we'll be majorly focusing on the MOSFETs as well as the integrated circuits like op amp. Okay. So this electronic circuit. Okay, there are two types, analog circuits and digital circuits. So in analog circuits also we have two types. One is discrete components circuit, another is IC, integrated circuit. Okay, so discrete component means you have done the lab last semester, right? you have a breadboard. So there you have taken the components, resistor, okay, different combination. You have taken the diodes also, you have connected it there. Okay, this is called as discrete components. So one by one components, its connection you have given and you formed a circuit and that you have analyzed it. So designed the circuit and analyzed it. That is called as discrete analog circuits. Okay, similarly IC. So in basic electronics part, you have learned op amp. Okay, so ideal characteristics of op amp, CMRR. So different characteristics you have learned. Okay, and basic circuits also you have seen like adder, subtractor, comparator, okay, integrator, differentiator. Okay, so these things only will continue with the advanced circuits here. So that's why this subject is having both discrete as well as integrated circuits. So what is the skills a student should require here, okay, or students should develop here is the design of these circuits. Okay, so it is first thing is you will be going to design such circuits. What is meant by design? You know already last time when doing lab, so write the design may be told by sir, right? So what is that design? So if you have a circuit with resistor and transistor, you need to identify the values of that components, right? Resistor, how much values I have to take to get a proper this one application. Okay, so that is the thing, design you have to do with this circuit. And then not only design, you have to analyze it because you are engineer. Okay, so that's why the high paid job in industry for electronics engineer is this. Okay, that is the design and analysis of circuits, especially in analog domain. Okay, so you have the huge potential of growing here. Okay, because the transistor we are dealing with here, that is a three terminal, and you know something about Q point, operating point of the transistor, so that you have to fix it properly. So that analysis is required. Sorry, this is analysis. Okay, so this is the major two things you have to learn throughout this subject. Okay, design and analysis of electronic circuits, analog circuits, that is discrete and integrated circuits. Okay, so hope it is clear, the two terms, circuits and analog. So circuit is electronic circuits, analog, so it is analog nature. Okay, so the value of a variable changes continuously with the time. Discrete means you will have either zero or one as the thing. Okay, hope it is clear, analog circuit. So this is the first subject you have. So now, so what are the contents? So what you are going to learn? So it is a very huge topic. As I told you, in control system, it is its own ocean. Same analog circuit is also very big subject. You could not learn everything in one semester. Okay, so that's why you have started with basic electronics, then electronic device and circuits. So now you have come to this level, analog circuits, and it is not going to stop over here. Okay, it may continue with some advanced subjects in the next semesters also. Okay, so that's why it is a continuation. So there are five modules are there with every subject. Okay, so here the subject will be classified into two here. As I told you, discrete and integrated circuit. Up to module 3 we'll be learning about discrete components, and module 4 and 5 I will be discussing about a linear integrated circuit, LIC it is called. It is also called as op amp circuits. Okay, and any transistor, okay, if you are discussing with MOSFET, so without discussing the BJT it is not a complete. Okay, so that's why here first module half part we'll be discussing about BJT. Okay, so just BJT biasing we'll start with. Okay, and within half we'll be completing that. Okay, then second half we start the MOSFET, and this MOSFET discussion will continue till next. Okay, so MOSFETs will again same biasing in MOSFETs will take up, then how we construct the amplifiers using MOSFETs. Okay, and there are applications are there. So these are the application circuits, analog circuits I told, no. So using MOSFETs or BJTs we'll construct the circuits, that is oscillators, so one of the circuit, then feedback amplifiers, and then power amplifiers. So this is what we have in the first part. Okay, that is module 1 to 3. For this you have a separate book. Okay, I will mention that books also in the next slide. Then module 4 and 5 is about op amp. Okay, in module 4 we will discuss about introduction to op amp, basic circuits we will see, and then in second part we'll go in detail with the different op amp circuits. Okay, practical circuits we'll see, and also we'll see the 555 timer and its applications. So this is also an IC 555, its name IC 555, and op amp is having the 741 number. Okay, so IC 741 is nothing but op amp. Okay, so in digital system design you have went through different IC names, right? 7402, 7486 for XOR gate, like that. Okay, so same way for op amp, this comes as a integrated circuit. Okay, that means if you see the block diagram of op amp, it will have many MOSFETs inside that. Okay, and there are tens or hundreds of MOSFETs connected together to form a op amp. That's why there are two types of analog circuits. I told, discrete and integrated circuit. Clear? Okay. So now I will show you the book what you have to refer for this. Okay. So that is the best book. Okay, as suggested by VTU and throughout the world. Okay, those who are learning analog circuits, or it is also called as microelectronic circuits, they will be referring the same contents. If they have to learn about MOSFET. Okay. Op amp. So these are the standard books. Okay, so that only they have suggested that I am going to show you. Okay, so this is the first part book. Okay, for modules 1, 2, and 3. So the contents are present in this book. So it is called as Microelectronic Circuits Theory and Applications. Okay, it is a 5th edition book available in library. So 6th edition also you can take. Okay, so that is not available in library. So 5th edition, plenty of books are available. So you can take one and you can read out. Okay, so Adele S. Sidra, Kenneth C. Smith, the author's name. It is a international authors. So it was translated in Indian version by Arun Chandur. Okay, so it is a Oxford International Student Edition book. Okay, so fat book. It is having plenty of chapters, but we are not going to take everything. Okay, so in the syllabus copy, it is mentioned in this book which are the contents we have to take, like 3.4, 3.5. 3.5.1, like that they have mentioned it. You have to tick it. Okay, so if you have not followed, just you can come and meet me after this one. Okay, so it's easily understood to you. So take your syllabus copy, analog circuits. Okay, so there in the beneath they have mentioned each module. Okay, in this book which contents you have to refer. Okay, so that is for module first 3. Okay, for discrete analog circuits. Then second part, where module 4 and 5, you have to refer this book. Okay, op amps and linear integrated circuits by Ramakant A. Gaikwad. So it is the 4th edition book from low price edition. Okay, so Pearson edition also it is available. So both are same. Okay, so this book you can refer. Okay, so this is about the basic introduction and which books to refer. Okay, so now we'll start with the module 1. So where it starts with the biasing of the BJT and MOSFETs. Okay, so what is biasing? So this you maybe went through in the previous semester also. Okay, so for this you require some basic revision. Okay, so what is that basic revision here? So what you know about transistor? So transistor operation. Okay, so it is available in two things. One is NPN and PNP. Okay, so there are two types of transistor in BJT, NPN and PNP. Okay, as I told you before discussing MOSFET, we have to complete the discussion on BJT. That's why first part you have the BJT. Okay, module 1 first part you have BJT, second part you have the MOSFETs, and that will be continued to second module. Okay, so then what is the basic operation of the transistor? If you so see the application of transistor or BJT, it will be two. One is you can use it as an amplifier. Okay, so just I am revising this if you have already went through. Okay, introduction class. And another one is it acts as an electronic switch. Okay, so you know what is meant by switch. Okay, so on off, its operation is on off. Amplifier is it should amplify your signal. For example, if you have a long auditorium, so the speaker will be speaking using the microphone in this stage. Okay, and there are thousands of students sitting in the auditorium, so they should listen. Okay, so front row they can see without the amplifier, but using the amplifier so you can audible through the loudspeaker, right? So the big speakers. Okay, so you know this applications. Okay, so that is called as an amplifier. The low amplitude your voice signal will be amplified to a high amplitude. Okay, whatever he is speaking, it will be audible to you in a loud manner. That is amplification. Okay, signal will be amplified. Switch is on off operation. Okay, so now when I say BJT amplifier circuit, so amplification means so you have to operate the transistor in certain region. Okay, so you know that there are three regions in a transistor characteristics. So if you see the transistor characteristics, okay. So what is transistor characteristic? It is a VI characteristics. V stands for here. It is the collector to emitter voltage called as VCE. Okay. And the current is nothing but the collector current. So if you have to bias the transistor, nothing but you have to get a certain current and voltage, and combination of that we call it as a point on this first quadrant. Okay. So that point we call it as operating point or quiescent point, or also called as Q point in short. Okay. So this Q point is very, very important, because if you set this Q point in different places, it will have different operation. Okay. So different analysis. Okay. So there are three regions are there again. So this one region we call it as cutoff region, where IB value is very zero. IB means what? Input current in the case of common emitter configuration. Okay. So again, transistor will be used in three configuration: common base, common emitter, and common collector configuration. So in the case of amplification, we will be using the transistor in common emitter configuration. So that is, this is the symbol of the transistor BJT. Okay. So here I could not write it neatly, so understand it. Okay. So you have the three terminals, base, and this is the collector side, and this is the emitter side. Okay. So emitter is common between the base and collector. So that's why base side will act as the input and collector emitter side as acts as the output. Okay. So E is common because it is grounded. So BE is input, CE is output, like that. Okay. So E is common between base and collector. That's why common emitter configuration. So you'll be using out of this. Okay. Why is CE configuration? You learned that already. Okay. So you'll be having the high power gain in CE. That means what? So if you use common base or common collector, either voltage gain is high, current gain is small, or current gain is high, voltage gain is small. Okay. So, but power gain is calculated as current gain into voltage gain. Both should be high, then only you'll have the power gain high. So CE amplifier configuration will give that high power gain. Okay. That's why CE configuration is used in amplification circuits. Okay. So that's why you will have normally this one in our notation. So base is left side, collector is output side, and emitter is this side. Similarly, if you apply the voltage here, so accordingly, if you apply the voltage at B side, we denote it as VBB. Okay. Or if you give the power supply to collector side, we call it as VCC. Okay. Similarly, at emitter side, if you connect, it is called as VEE. So these are some of the notations. And in the DC biasing, we will use everything capital. The letter also capital, its subscript also will write it in capital. Okay. Later we have small signal operation or AC analysis. Okay. So this is called as biasing, is called as DC analysis of the amplifier circuits. So in the DC analysis, we'll use everything capital, letter as well as subscript capital. Okay. So there are other notations we'll discuss next, so you'll not get confused. Okay. So at present, so this is the case. So when you have common emitter configuration now, so when you draw the characteristics in common emitter configuration, the current coming to the base is the input current. This is the IB. Okay. So this, you know, so some of the relation, and collector side current is IC. Okay. And you know the important transistor current relation, which is nothing but IE is equal to IC plus IB. Okay. So just you can note down. Okay. These are the basic things you should not forget. You have learned from basic electronics also, electronic devices, circuits, you have done lab also. Okay. So that's why you should not be confused with this. You should be perfect with this. Okay. Then what about the IC current? IC current is given as beta times IB. Okay. So beta times IB. So IC is the output current for common emitter configuration. So if you are getting confused, not understanding, please go and read this at least transistor introduction part. Okay. So all these things, it will be explained. So IB is the input current for common emitter configuration. Don't confuse. This same IB may be changing in different configuration, common collector, common base, the input current, output current, everything, it will change. Okay. But I am now purely discussing in this subject common emitter configuration. Okay. You know already the difference. Okay. So IC is the output current, IB is the input current, and beta is called as the current gain here. Pardon? So kindly unmute. Is there any doubts? Okay. So collector current is the output current, IB is the input current. So output current by input current is current gain. So beta is the parameter in the case of DC. Okay. This same beta in the AC analysis, we call it as the HFE because we'll be using their H parameter model. Last time we have learned, right? Two port networks, H parameters, I mentioned there. Okay. So this same beta, also called as HFE in normally data sheet, HFE will be given, beta will not be written. Okay. So this is nothing but beta. It is the current gain. Okay. Similarly, how you relate the emitter current with collector current? So, collector current IC will relate to IE by alpha. IC is equal to alpha times IE. So this beta value varies from value 25 to 250. Okay. So in the normal transistor, 25 to 250, we will be used two types of transistor in last time lab. That is either BC107, am I right? Or SL100. We will be used either of these two for BJT. Okay. So it is the SL100. So if their specifications you see, so their beta values will vary from 25 to 250 range. Okay. It may be 50, 100 or 200, whatever. Okay. Normally solving the problem, they will give this value. Okay. Then similarly, alpha value. So alpha value varies from normally 0.9 to 0.99. Okay. Or 0 to 1, its range. It will not exceed more than 1. Okay. 0.995 or 999 like that. So that's why IC current and IE current are approximately equal. Okay, so there is no much difference between IC and IE, but IB and IC, there is a huge difference because of this transistor gain. Okay, so that is what about amplification. So this is the collector. So VI characteristics I am discussing. This is the collector current IC, which first you have to. Okay, so very basic thing only forgot. So for acting as an amplifier, BJT acting as an amplifier, there will be two junctions in the transistor. As I told you, NPN and PNP. So you will be forming two junctions here. If you are taking NPN, so NP is one junction, another PN is another junction. PNP also, if you take, PN is one junction, NP is another junction. So these junctions are named as, one is emitter base junction and another junction is named as collector base junction. So what is their status when it is acting as amplifier? So this is the emitter base in the common emitter configuration. This is the emitter side and this is the base. So this is emitter base junction. So here a PN junction is there. Similarly, collector and base, here also one junction is there. So for normal transistor amplification, emitter base junction should be forward bias. So this is the rule, and collector base junction should be reverse bias. So then your transistor will act as an amplifier. If you make both emitter base junction and collector base junction as reverse bias, what is that called as? So that is called as the cutoff region. Okay. Or it is off. It will act as a switch. Okay. Off state. And if the both are forward bias, then we call it as saturation region. Okay. So that will be shown this side. Okay. So this side of the circuit will be shown as saturation and this side will be shown as cutoff region. Okay. And this one region where emitter base junction is forward bias and collector base junction is reverse bias, that is called as the active region. Okay. So if you have to make the transistor working as an amplifier, it should be in the active region. And here the engineer's role is to place that operating point or cue point in this active region. Okay. In a proper manner. Okay. So to do that, so we will be doing the BJT biasing. Okay. So whatever, just a minute. I have last 10 minutes. Okay. So just I will wind up. So next class we can continue that. Okay. So just I'm giving the introduction. Hope it is revision. Okay. Okay. So now you have understood. So you have to make first transistor in active region. Okay. That is what our interest here in this module. Okay. BJT biasing and MOSFET biasing both. Okay. So MOSFET, the just symbol is changed and its working is different. Okay. So this is the MOSFET symbol looks like. So the terminals are changed. So in the place of base, you will have the gate. In the place of collector, you will have the drain. In the case of emitter, we have the source GDS, gate drain source. Okay, so that is your MOSFET symbol. So that will take up in second part. Okay, the same discussion it may use it for MOSFET. Okay, so BJT biasing, we'll be using the BJT in common emitter configuration for amplification. Common emitter configuration, output current is collector current and output voltage is VCE. That is the collector to emitter voltage is the output voltage. Okay, so that only we have to draw the characteristics. So if you draw the characteristics, you are getting like this. Okay, so this is the characteristics. So you'll be getting, I hope, so you can recall this. Okay, and in that, so where you fix the operating point, based on that you will have the maximum voltage swing for IC as well as VCE. So where you will get that maximum output voltage swing means what? If you have applied a this one input signal, a very small amplitude input signal, so you should get a amplification where exactly it should give a magnification, equal magnification, both negative part as well as positive part. So if you get here upper part clipped off and lower part it is coming full, then it is not called as a complete swing. Okay, so that's why this depends on the operating point. You may be seen the diagrams in previous subject. Okay, ADC, I don't know how you have done or not. Okay, so that will happen. Okay, if you does not select the operating point exactly in the middle, some point is there. Okay, so that is the engineer's task, that is done by the various biasing circuits. Okay, so we'll be learnt about fixed bias circuits, emitter bias circuits, voltage divider bias circuit, collector to base bias circuit, like that plenty of biased circuits are there. So in that we'll be studying the various circuits here, and in each cases the operating point may vary. Okay, so here for BJT we have two circuits that we are going to discuss. Okay, in this, and then we'll take the small signal operation, AC analysis we'll do. Okay, so AC analysis and DC analysis we are going to do in module 1 of the BJT in the first part. Okay, so DC analysis means biasing, biasing means various biasing circuits to fix the, get the operating point. Operating point is nothing but combination of output current and output voltage in common emitter configuration is IC comma VCE. Okay, so then IC is beta times IB. Okay, beta is the current gain and IC is alpha times IE. Okay, so VC is the output voltage and VB is the input voltage, and for silicon transistor VB value is 0.7. okay, so these are all the small things you have learned in previous semesters. So whichever is required to understand this topic, I just took up. Okay, so hope it is clear to you. Fine, so if you have any doubts you can tell me. Okay, so we'll clarify that. Okay, so this is about the required things, just to brush up to understand this continuation. Okay, if anything is not understanding, you can refer the previous, or I told you Wikipedia you can use, Google you can do. Okay, and try to understand. Okay, fine. So this is about the module 1. Okay, so it is exactly, chapter names are not there, I only given these names. Okay, it's a continuous discussion on the topic what you have come stopped in the last EDC. okay, so BJT biasing and MOSFETs is our interest. Okay, so what we are going to learn, so it is divided into four parts. Okay, so first part we'll be learning biasing in BJT amplifier circuits. I told you two circuits I have that I'm going to discuss and problems with that. Okay, second part I will be doing AC analysis of BJT, so small signal operation and models we call that. Okay, so that we'll do in this part. Different models are there, like you have H parameter model, hybrid pi model, then RE model. Okay, so like the different models are there, but you are not going to go through all the models, only one model you will be learning. Okay, that is hybrid pi model, about that we will be discussing here. So this completes the BJT discussion for this. Okay, next we'll take the MOSFET, the same thing whatever you have done. Again, I am not going through MOSFET, what is MOSFET, what is its operation. Okay, so what is its output current, output voltage, nothing I am going to do. Okay, so what is the one basic difference between BJT and MOSFET is, BJT is a current control device. That means I told you here output current is IC, so input current is IB, so it is current control. Okay, but whereas in MOSFET it is a voltage control device. So you may be seen when you are drawing the characteristics in last semester, the output current depends on the input voltage. What is the input voltage there? VGS. Okay, fixing the VG, you may be heard about. Okay, gate to source voltage will be the input voltage. Varying that, you will get the different current. Okay, IC. That's why it is called as voltage controlled device. That is the major difference between BJT and MOSFET. Within nothing other than that, everything it is three terminal device. Okay, so it's also operating point will be same way it is defined. Okay, and its characteristics you know. So same way we have to do some biasing circuits we'll be seeing in that case, and its small signal operation and models. Okay, and that discussion will continue in the module 2 also. Okay, so today it is sufficient. So we may be having next class also. Okay, tomorrow we'll be discussing this first part, biasing in BJT amplifier circuits. We'll start up. Like that we'll do. Okay, so 8 hours is required to complete this online mode. It may be 10 hours also. So as per timetable we will take the class. Okay, so tomorrow we have first hour class, so colleges will be off, but I will be taking from home only the class. Okay, so 9:30 is my period Saturday, so I will be taking that, the first part. Okay, so please be wake up early and ready for the class tomorrow. Okay, thank you.